الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله العلي العظيم من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح للأمة وكشف الغمة وجاهد في سبيل الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين فاجزه اللهم عنا خير ما جزيت رسولًا عن أمته ونبيًا عن قومه وارض اللهم عن أصحابه وأزواجه وذريته والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين ثم أما بعد. Brother, if I can ask you not to tape without permission, Jazakallah khair. My topic today, as we are living, subhanAllah, in a time and a space, the time is the month of Ramadan, almost halfway. And typically, it is the fastest month that goes by of the year. It's the most powerful month, the most important month, and at the same time, it goes by so fast, but so much can go on in this month and takes place. And typically, we talk about the famous ayat in the month of Ramadan because it's the month of Quran. شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. And we talk about ليلة القدر. And we start some math calculations. خير من ألف شهر. The night of Al-Qadr is better than 1,000 nights, and we multiply the time, it's 85 years. And the hasanat are multiplied. And I wanted to share with you today something I personally never had the opportunity from Allah Azza wa Jalla to access the Quran. And I want to zoom in into surah number 40. The title of the surah is Surah Ghafir. Ghafir, it is representing one of the names of Allah Azza wa Jalla, Al-Ghaffar. And the topic of Ghufran, Maghfirah, forgiveness. And this is the month of Ramadan, the month of Quran. And let us together, hopefully, we can dot some I's and cross some T's and connect some dots. Map the whole thing together. How does it work? And let's zoom in into Surah number 40, Ayah number 40. Allah Azza wa Jal says, Subhanallah, A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan ar-rajim, Bismillahi ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. من عمل سيئة فلا يجزى إلا مثلها ومن عمل صالحا من ذكر أو أنثى وهو مؤمن فأولئك يدخلون الجنة يرزقون فيها بغير حساب. من عمل صالحا, العمل الصالح, we know good deeds. It's Sharia compliant, simple, pure. Compliance to the Quran and the teachings of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Min dhakarin aw untha. And the fascination in this ayah. Why Allah did not talk about al-mu'mineen, the believers, general term. Why he didn't say you, minkum. He went ahead to really precisely define who is the target here. Min dhakarin aw untha. And we always have this challenge in doing things, ibadat, men and women, males and females, and the rights of men and the rights of women, and all this big mess that the human society nowadays don't even understand the essence of it. That there is no clash between man and woman, male and female. They perfectly complement each other. They can never be each other. They complement each other. A man can never be a woman, and a woman can never be a man, and so forth. Min dhakarin aw untha. So Allah Azza wa Jalla here opens the door for competition. Equal playing field, equal opportunity. Min dhakarin aw untha. Did not specify age, culture, language, anything. Because it seems like this amal salih, that the male can sometimes be excelling in, and the other amal salih, the woman or the female, can be excelling in more than the man. But at the end, it's equal opportunity. That's how Allah Azza wa Jal puts it before us. And the condition, وَهُوَ مُؤْمِن. Because how can you do good deed? You will be rewarded in life. Those who are not believers do good deeds, they will be rewarded in this dunya. For their charity, for their goodness, for their hearts, for their humbleness, for their kindness and contributions, and in science, in anything good for humanity, they will be rewarded because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is just and fair. But the akhirah will only belong to the believers. It's just fair and justice too. وَهُوَ مُؤْمِن فَأُولَٰئِكَ. Those will enter Jannah. But maybe you're not paying attention. The ayah started with something, one of the most significant accounting in the deen of Islam. مَنْ عَمِلَ سَيِّئَةً فَلَا يُجْزَى إِلَّا بِهَا. If you make a sin, you will be accountable against one. Not 10 times the sin. Not 70 times. Not 1,000. It's not multiplied. Allah says that if you do one sin, you will be only accountable for one. But if you do a good deed, are you going to be rewarded just one? And let's see, the ayah tells us, فَأُولَٰئِكَ يَدْخُلُونَ الْجَنَّةِ. They will enter paradise. They're doing good deeds now. How many? That's not the point. يَدْخُلُونَ الْجَنَّةِ. That's number one priority, to enter Jannah. يُرْزَقُونَ فِيهَا بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. يُرْزَقُونَ, in Arabic grammar, it's a verb. And it's present continuous. This is the most powerful structure in the Arabic language, that you will be entering Jannah and you will have rizq all the time, non-stop, infinity, بغير حساب. There's no حساب. 10 times. But the sayyah, the bad deed, is only one for one. The good deeds is not 10 times. Because sometimes you say, subhanAllah, in Ramadan, if you do good deed, it's 10 times. Plus, multifolds, because it's a month of Ramadan. But in this ayah, Allah Azza wa Jalla is telling us, بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. It's not fair, it's not respect, it's not being polite to Allah Azza wa Jalla to tell him, why are you giving me 10 times for doing a good deed? 100, 1,000, it's infinity. And in our custom, we say that the sky is the limit. But in this ayah, Allah Azza wa Jalla is really changing this. He's not putting a limit to it, whether it's the sky and beyond. So just imagine, in this month, as we are doing good deeds, and you have that faith in your heart, you will be entering Jannah and rewarded infinity. Because that's how we should have our faith and our expectations of our Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala al-Ghaffar. This is Surah Ghafir. Now, I'll take you to the next two ayat, because that's the core why all of this is happening. Allah Azza wa Jal says on the Prophet's behalf, he said, وَيَا قَوْمِ, O my people, وَيَا قَوْمِ مَالِيَ أَدْعُوكُمْ إِلَى النَّجَاتِ وَتَدْعُونَنِي إِلَى النَّارِ. Why? I am inviting you to najat, escaping hellfire and salvation, and you are inviting me to hellfire. تَدْعُونَنِي, you are asking me, you are inviting me, لِأَكْفُرَ بِاللَّهِ, to deny my Lord and the existence of Allah, kufr. And we always said in Arabic, kufr means you cover up the truth. And that's why the farmer is a kafir as a profession, because he covers the seeds under the soil so they can have the opportunity to grow. Al-kafir, in linguistically, is a farmer who covers the seeds. Faithfully or religiously, he covers the truth, he doesn't believe in it. He knows about it, but he covers up. تَدْعُونَنِي لِأَكْفُرَ بِاللَّهِ وَأُشْرِكَ بِهِ. So what's the difference between kufr and shirk? Kufr, you cover up the truth, you don't believe. But shirk, you go further than that to actually create your own Lord, create your own God, create your own rules, your own rights and wrongs, and the desires would control you, shaitan would control you. Shirk fillah. Which means it is absolutely not only denial, but working against God. وَأُشْرِكَ بِهِ مَا لَيْسَ لِي بِهِ عِلْمٍ. Because sometimes, yani the beauty of Quran and the politeness, subhanAllah, Allah Azza wa Jal teaches us politeness even with the non-believers, with the enemy. He is telling, he's asking, he's arguing that لَخَلْقُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ أَكْبَرُ مِنْ خَلْقِكُمْ. The creation of the heavens of the earth is more complex than the creation of mankind. أَفَلَا تُبْصِرُونَ أَفَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ أَفَلَا تَتَذَكَّرُونَ. Allah Azza wa Jalla, his argument is extremely challenging, polite, respectful, given the opportunity. Just like in Surah Al-Buruj, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ فَتَنُوا الْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتِ ثُمَّ لَمْ يَتُوبُ. Those who give fitna to the believers, challenge them in their faith and their rights and their dignity and honor and their right to life by killing them. And the condition here, Allah still is giving them opportunity, ثُمَّ لَمْ يَتُوبُ, and they did not repent. Which means those who give fitna to the believers have the opportunity to repent, and Allah will accept it. تَدْعُونَنِي لأكفر بالله وأشرك به ما ليس لي به علم، وأنا أدعوكم إلى العزيز الغفار. And the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is inviting us to Al-Aziz, the Supreme, Al-Ghaffar. And Ghaffar, in Arabic, in the verb, it's coming emphasis. Ghaffar, Ghafir, Ghaffar. Rahim, Rahman. Kafir, Kaffar. So this is a huge, powerful Ghaffar. It's the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the surah is telling us about Maghfirah. And it's the month of Qur'an. It means that Rasulullah ﷺ sunnah, his tradition, is part of the belief. وَهُوَ مُؤْمِنٌ. And some people, unfortunately, the trends, you know, ya akhi, and I always say this, wallahi, it breaks my heart. Wallahi, I even cannot cry, shed tears, that when I hear a Muslim, a believer, says, ya akhi, it's only sunnah. It's only a sunnah. It's like, it has no value. It says, Rasulullah ﷺ has no value. His traditions, no value. You know what that means? Who brought the Quran itself to us? It's Rasulullah ﷺ himself. So the highest level of his tradition is the Quran. By denying the sunnah, you deny the Quran. And when we say Islam is surrendering, Islam is peace, to surrender to the Lord. This has a powerful, heavy liability, commitment, sacrifice. It's not a peace, it's not a joke. It's not you saying, I can do this, and then you fall short of completing. It is a matter of really hardcore faith in your heart. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala set the condition, male or female, وَهُوَ مُؤْمِنٌ. You have to be a believer. You have to have the faith. And that's why you're fasting. You have to have the faith that Allah will reward you. You have to have the faith. When you give sadaqah, brothers and sisters, when any organization trustworthy of receiving charity comes in and you give, remember it falls in the hands of Allah before it gets the check cashed from your bank or your credit card. Or before you see it on the statement, before a blink of an eye, if anything happens, if you are mu'min and sincere, and that's why Aisha used to go beyond that, radiyallahu anha. Our mother, the mother of the believers, Aisha radiyallahu anha, she used to have to clean the money and add perfume to it before she would give it as a sadaqah. This is how deep the sadaqah is. You have to have that faith. When you give sadaqah, when you give zakah, it falls in the hands of Allah. Many people worry, oh, is my money going to get there? Is my money going to, what are you going to do with my, it's not your money anyway to begin with. You are a custodian for it. You better hurry up and invest before it's too late. Free up yourself. Earn freedom of this money, the filth in the dunya. Give it up, because it's not yours. And that's why this ayah tells us to believe. You have to believe your effort. You will be rewarded. يدخلون الجنة. يدخلون also, it's a present continuous. It's like you have this ease of accessing Jannah. You don't have to be held back by the bad sins that one for one. مَنْ عَمِلَ سَيِّئَةً فَلَا يُجْزَى إِلَّا مِثْلَهَا. Subhanallah. What more mercy? Can you believe if you have a business and you have an employee and makes a mistake and steals $1 and you tell him you have to pay me 10. I'm going to fire you. I'm going to do this. But yet, if they repent, are you going to accept their repentance? And are you going to accept them back? But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, subhanallah, day in and day out, we see it in the media, we see it in social media, we see it in everywhere. It's so easy to curse the Lord. It's free, it's cheap, freedom of speech. But you better be careful about talking about certain things in this culture or that culture. You will go to jail because you violate someone else's right. But when Allah's right is violated, who cares? It's freedom of speech, freedom of religion. You can believe in whatever you want. But for us, our goal is clear. Our mission is very clear. The month of Ramadan is so clear. You are rewarded. You're tired. No food, no drink. And I will conclude now to remind each and every one of us, and I start with myself, that the ear has to fast too. The eye has to fast. The nose has to fast. And most importantly, the mouth, the tongue has to fast. We focus so much on the stomach and we forget what's more important. Otherwise, Allah Azza wa Jalla will only, what do you get? You get hungry and that's the end of it. There's nothing else. How are you going to be part of those فَأُولَٰئِكَ يَدْخُلُونَ الْجَنَّةَ وَيُرْزَقُونَ فِيهَا بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ? There's no accounting. Just imagine today, after this Jum'ah, as soon as you can, commit to a sadaqah and never ever count on the volume, count on the quality. I earn it from halal. I am sincere for the sake of Allah. I am going to give it without no one knows except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I have a faith that it will fall in the hand of Allah and I will enter Jannah and I will be rewarded without accounting. Just have that faith. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله حمد الشاكرين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ولي الصالحين المصلحين المخلصين المخلصين. الله أسأل أن يجعلني وإياكم منهم. وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله عليه أفضل الصلاة وأزكى التسليم بأبي وأمي يا رسول الله. Dear my brothers and sisters, Ramadan is like a marketplace, dealing and wheeling, trading, investing. Be careful on your return of investment. Have everything fasting. Your eyes, your ears, your mouth, your nose, your stomach, your throat, your hands and your legs. And share this with others. Bring life to your family, to your home. Be alive and remember, life is in water. وَجَعَلْنَا مِنَ الْمَاءِ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ حَيٍّ. Allah made life from water. But we have a pond that has water, but it's still water. It's contaminated. You cannot drink it, although it has life. It might have fishes. It has plants. And look at the river where it's running pure. You can drink, you can enjoy. It's strong, it's powerful. It cleanses itself, moving. Be dynamic in your iman. Be dynamic in your faith. Come to Taraweeh with energy in your iman. Iman will drive your energy. And I will conclude with one last example. How come we have people, young people, in their teens and in their 20s and 30s going to the gym, muscles and strength and pumping weight, but they cannot stand in Taraweeh. They don't come to Fajr. And we have senior people. Physically, they are so weak, but spiritually and iman-wise, they are very powerful and strong. So the issue is not the body, it's the self, it's the soul. If we focus on that, you will convert the true imani muscles into action. You will love Taraweeh. You will be crying after Ramadan that Taraweeh is over. So therefore, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us that spiritual and soul strength so we can enjoy our deen and have that beautiful journey ending in entering Jannah. يَدْخُلُونَ الْجَنَّةَ يُرْزَقُونَ رِزْق. And risk here, it's not defined. It's everything beyond our imagination. يُرْزَقُونَ فِيهَا بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. اللَّهُمَّ رَزُقْنَا الْجَنَّةَ وارزقنا فيها من الرزق بغير حساب. اللهم آمين. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا وتوفنا مع الأبرار. ربنا تقبل منا صيامنا وقيامنا وصدقاتنا وزكواتنا. اللهم آمين. يا غفار اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وارحم لنا ضعفنا واجبر كسرنا. اللهم كن لأمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم في كل مكان. اللهم انصر عبادك المستضعفين في كل مكان. اللهم ولي عليهم خيارهم ولا تولي عليهم شرارهم. اللهم كن معهم ولا تكن عليهم. اللهم إنهم ضعفاء فقوهم. اللهم إنهم جوعى فأطعمهم. اللهم إنهم حفاة فاحملهم. اللهم إنهم مستضعفين فانتصر لهم وانتقم لهم ولأرحامهم ولأعراضهم ولدمائهم. اللهم أكرمنا يا رب العالمين. May Allah bless us to live until the end of Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us live and healthy and strong to the next Ramadan. And may Allah accept from us our fasting and our sadaqat. Allahumma ameen. Allahumma shfi mardana wa mardan muslimin. Warham mawtana wa mawtal muslimin. Birahmatika arhamar rahimin. Fi hadha al-yawm al-azim. Fi hadha al-shahr al-azim. يا غفار يا عزيز يا غفار اغفر لنا إنك على ما تشاء قدير وبالإجابة جدير. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين وأقم الصلاة.